It is hard to imagine the seas, the largest mass of water that covers three quarters of the earth, suddenly begin to froth and boil. We have no previous experience to help us imagine the terror of that moment. We can picture it to some extent, perhaps by pushing the bounds of our imaginations. The earth will disgorge all its weight on that day. This means that the subterranean stratum, at a temperature of around 4,500 degrees, will pour out of everywhere it can do so. This will also certainly apply to that which is beneath the sea. Anyone who has seen the progress of lava under the sea on a documentary program has witnessed a stunning scene. Yet the scene that will emerge on the Day of Judgment will be far different, far more wide-ranging, and far more terrifying. All the seas on the earth will burn, and an unstoppable mass of fire and flame will head towards human beings. All the seas will solidify on that day. Allah tells us this in the relevant verse. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan, when the oceans surge into each other. As a result of the events that take place, life in the sea will come to an end, just like that on land. The seas, which normally cause feelings of cool and comfort, will suddenly begin giving off an incredible heat. Clouds of flame will replace the giant waves in the oceans, and the smoke in the air will consume much of the oxygen there. The picture of the boundless seas burning and bubbling fiercely will prevail over much of the world and bring many catastrophes with it. The overflowing of the seas is one of the phenomena the Quran tells us will take place on the Day of Judgment. By the will of Allah, disasters in the sea will be added to those on land on the Day of Judgment. It is sufficient for Allah to so will for this and similar catastrophes to take place. Allah is mighty enough to destroy all the life forms He created on earth from nothing by just telling them to be. The probable causes that will bring all this about are merely reminders for us, a means of drawing close to Allah and fearing His wrath. The way these events will take place and what their causes will be is known only in the sight of Allah. There may be no direct cause, and the Day of Judgment may begin suddenly in all its manifestations. Some instances that may well take place are to do with the overflowing of the sea. It is a known fact that when an earthquake occurs underneath the sea, giant waves form on the surface. The waves that spread from the epicenter head rapidly for the shore at surface speeds of up to 750 kilometers per hour. Waves not even 1 meter tall in the middle of the ocean can rise to several meters in height when they reach the shore. A similar wave following the Indonesian earthquake led to the deaths of hundreds of thousands of people. As we have seen, although earthquakes or volcanic eruptions that take place under the sea affect only a specific region, they also cause the seas to overflow and kill thousands of people. Yet on the Day of Judgment, in the same way that nothing will be left standing above the ground, so nothing will be left unshaken beneath the sea. The seas will therefore overflow due to the powerful tremors occurring underneath them, and this will impact the whole world in a manner incomparably more powerful than that tsunamis we know today.